rolling. Hello, hello, hello. Okay, I'm ready to go.
Don't mind us.
I'll go first.
Mr. Hannaford, is the camera eye a reflection of reality, or is reality a reflection of the camera eye? Or is the camera merely a phallus?
I want a drink.
You heard him. Let's get it out here.
We ought to start with a broader spectrum.
Here.
Don't you agree, Otterlake?
That's true. The interview's for everybody, not just us.
But today there's a special dispensation.
Mr. Hannaford, could you please to slow down? Otherwise, I'm going to fall off the car.
Mr. Hannaford!
Sarah Valeska, take one, scene two. Well, Sarah, speaking of great men, your name has been linked romantically with quite a few celebrities.
Wasn't it understood that we weren't going to talk about love affairs? What you agreed to talk about is Mr. Hannaford.
It's been reported that you call him GF sometimes. Jokingly, of course. Is that right? GF meaning God the Father?
I call Mr. Hannaford, Mr. Hannaford.
Darling, this marvelous bash you're giving him. If I understand, your whole idea was to get Jake Hannaford in touch with the new generation.
And vice versa, yes.
Very few of your guests are his own age.
Most people of Mr. Hannaford's age are too old for him.
Hey, beautiful.
Hello.
We don't have much of a past, do we, beautiful?
We made just half of a picture together.
That was in Miss Valeska's country.
In Austria.
What happened?
Hitler. That's what happened.
He threw you out?
She threw him out. Her USO troop led our armies into battle. I witnessed it from the rear.
But you did liberate the rich.
Oh, her friend Hemingway put in for that.
Jake was three miles ahead of them.
Hemingway, that left hook of his was overrated.
Every man contains within himself the whole condition of humanity.
Write that down, somebody.
Somebody did.
She even gave me the book.
Mr. Hannaford enjoys pretending to be ignorant.
Then she spoiled the present by telling me who gave it to her.
Who? Oh, just someone he doesn't happen to like.
The queers adore great women.
They like all women, Uncle. They're the only sex that does.
True. Real men never like us. Men only like men.
And women keep us away from each other.
Ah, but if I cut him off, we ask ourselves. Cut him off from all his good companions. What will be left of him? An amputee, perhaps? An emotional basket case?
You chop away, all the same. Half a man is better than none.